I've always been fascinated by the desks of highly creative people. They're often layered with minutiae and covered in research notes, references, and so many other things. What's compelling about them to me isn't exactly what's on them, but the way that everything comes together to enhance people's lives and work. There's something special about having a desk full of everything that's important to you, even if it's a little chaotic, that allows you to be more productive than if, say, you decided to shove everything into a filing cabinet to make things more tidy. I believe that in the same way that a cluttered desk should let you just get to work, note-taking apps should do the same thing. Yet as someone who likes having everything important to me at arm's length, I found it super challenging to make my brain work the same way that many note-taking apps seem to. I've tried them all, but nothing has worked exactly the way that I want it to until now. There's a new tool that I've been using that I feel has single-handedly transformed my creative process from a scattered mess into something intensely productive: Rome Research. Rome is a new tool that I've been talking about with every single person I know, which I think has been getting a little annoying. This is especially true because note-taking apps in the year 2020 are definitely well-trodden territory, so it doesn't sound like a super interesting subject to everyone. But Rome is doing something really different. Let me explain. Rome is able to remove the mental weight of note-taking by providing you with something similar to a mind map. As you write whatever comes to mind, you can use a set of double brackets, and Rome will generate a new page for whatever that subject might be. These bi-directional links work in a similar way to what you're accustomed to seeing on a site like a wiki. This simple change in the way that ideas are linked together makes all the difference. With a typical note-taking system, I have to do the work of remembering where I wrote something down and how it might relate to other notes. In Rome, pages are automatically linked if there's a connection between them. I might be watching a video by Craig Maad and find it so interesting that I want to take notes on it.
I'm Craig Maad and I am exhausted.
Then, as I'm watching and writing, I might be reminded of something else. In this case, an article by Stephen Pressfield on never stopping between projects. What makes Rome amazing is that every idea that you consider worthwhile enough to get its own page just gets one without you having to do any work besides typing those brackets. Two books and a long walk, it gets its own page where any writing related to that will live. Craig Maad, he gets his own page because beyond this talk, he writes incredible essays that I want to link together later. Stephen Pressfield, he definitely gets his own page because I'm a Stephen Pressfield junkie and I want to collect everything that he writes. But in this case, I chose not to create a page for his article because there weren't any notes that I wanted to take on it that I felt couldn't just live on his author page. But hey, you could do that. Rome works however you want it to, and there's no one right path. By creating these pages, I've not only written some notes, but I've created a connection between Maad's talk and Pressfield's article. And that connection is powerful because linking ideas together is incredible fodder for forming your own original thoughts. And in Rome, it just works. Research shows that we are severely limited in what we can remember, holding a maximum of somewhere around 7 things in our mind at any time. The trick that memory artists use to remember more is not by somehow upping the amount of thoughts they can store, but by bundling information in meaningful ways. And there's evidence that everybody's memory works by constantly bundling information all the time. Our ability to connect or bundle information is a massive skill that we are very, very good at. And Rome helps you get in the habit of bundling, of connecting, and then offloading. And connecting your own thoughts in a system like Rome not only makes you more likely to remember it later, it frees you up to write more, to think more, to connect more. You're able to let go of the mental weight of whatever you're thinking about by offloading it all to your collection in Rome. And when you read an article that you like, or a chapter in a book that's interesting, or you watch a video that you end up loving, Rome helps you connect all of those ideas in a meaningful way, instead of just creating lonely little islands of thought. If this is all sounding a little confusing to you, that might be because we've become very accustomed to thinking about notes in terms of files and folders. It's what we've been using since the dawn of computing, and of course even before that. But files and folders aren't necessarily a great way to think. Files and folders keep us from linking ideas together, and having a tool that does that work for you quickly becomes invaluable. Rome also provides a visual graph of every page that you've ever made, showing how each interconnects with the other. This is way more powerful than you might realize. I can't count how many times I've found myself clicking on this graph and recognizing how a note is connected to other ideas which I would have never thought of as related. Having this high-level view of my own notes in a way feels like looking at my own subconscious as I make connections that I wouldn't have otherwise made. Here's my initial graph after some use. This was a couple of weeks. That's a lot of connections, right? Here's where I'm at today. It just keeps growing like a sourdough starter for your mind. Rome encourages you to see your notebook as a living document that's building upon itself constantly instead of seeing each note as something that needs to be written and completed. This was particularly helpful to me because over the past few years, I really had been struggling in my creative process. There was a time years ago when I committed myself to writing at least 500 words every day, and I did it. But this skill languished over time to the point where I found it very difficult to write even a couple of hundred words. And then if I did manage to write those words, I would leave them incomplete, trapped in a note-taking app and forgotten. In Rome, the fact that everything is connected means that nothing important slips through the cracks. I don't have to consider where my thoughts are going to live or what category something should be filed under. I just think of an idea and start writing. Rome has become the digital version of that cluttered desk that I've been looking for. Instead of some perfectly structured tool that doesn't work the way that I do, I've created a space of organized chaos and pure creativity. I no longer find myself worrying about taking the perfect note. I just add what I want, let ideas connect to other ideas, and keep everything within reach so that I can get to work. If this has sounded interesting to you, give Rome a try and create a digital desk of your own.